Hi, I'm Hugh Hewitt, the president of the Richard Nixon Foundation. I'm so glad that you're here to celebrate with us on Pat Nixon's birthday. She was a woman of many firsts, as no doubt many of you of the right age remember. But if you don't remember Mrs. Nixon personally, let me tell you a little bit about all the things that she accomplished. She was born on March 16th of 1912 to a very humble family, but she never lacked for confidence. She never lacked for self-courage. She never lacked for drive or ambition. She was the only woman of the family, in fact, and she took it upon herself to support her older brothers, working at odd jobs as a janitor, as a driver, a telephone operator, a movie extra, whatever work that was to be had in Southern California. Pat Nixon would do it. In fact, at one point, she drove across the country in the service of her family. She enrolled at the University of Southern California. Now, we all like to give the USC Trojans a hard time, but it was quite the thing at the time that Pat Nixon was going to be a young female attending Trojan land in Southern California. At the time that Pat Nixon enrolled at USC, only 1 in 10 women in America were receiving a bachelor's, and Pat Nixon was one of those 1 in 10. When Pat Nixon graduated from USC, she continued her studies, eventually earning the equivalent of a master's. Until recently, she was the most educated First Lady ever, until, of course, Hillary Clinton, with her law degree from Yale, entered the White House as First Lady with Bill Clinton. After she graduated from college, Pat Nixon began her career as a high school teacher, and she met and eventually married a young lawyer by the name of Richard Nixon. They settled in Whittier, California, where Richard Nixon began his law practice. As even a cursory reading of Richard Nixon's memoir, RN, will tell you, Pat Nixon was at his side every step of the way. When Richard Nixon became vice president, Mrs. Nixon broke precedent for second ladies, engaging in more than just the teas and luncheons that had marked the office to that date, going outside of the office, going to orphanages, meeting with the distressed and the humble in every country that they visited. Pat Nixon took it upon herself to represent the United States in its best sense. Her many trips as second lady allowed her later as first lady to claim the title that she still holds, the most traveled first lady in history. She was the first First Lady to visit China, the first First Lady to visit Africa, the first First Lady to go so many different places, and also the first First Lady to be caught in a life-threatening riot in Venezuela. She was, by the way, the first First Lady to ever visit an active combat zone, Pat Nixon, Vietnam. Pat Nixon used her platform as First Lady to make the White House accessible, bringing to the White House such things as wheelchair ramps, which we take for granted now, and tours for the blind. Pat Nixon was all about being the First Lady of all the people of the United States. The Richard Nixon Foundation is celebrating Pat Nixon's legacy, as it does every year, with the Day of Service on March 14th of this year, but a day that is always as close to her birthday, March 17th, as is possible, a day when we open the grounds of the foundation and the library to all of the community organizations with which Pat Nixon was at one time or another associated or worked closely with. And believe me, the variety is astonishing, as was her efforts to bring to the community a little bit of the energy and sparkle of the White House. Learn more about the Pat Nixon Day of Service and more about Pat Nixon at the NixonFoundation.org. That's NixonFoundation.org.